In this screencast, we're going to look at the solution to a semi-batch reactor, an isothermal reactor, in which we have a catalytic reaction. It's a second-order reaction where it's first-order in the reactant and first-order in the catalyst, which is component B. So initially, the reactor starts out with 2,700 liters of a solution that contains our reactant A. And then we add catalyst B continuously. We start out with no catalyst in the reactor, and then we start adding at a constant rate. So as the concentration of A decreases due to reaction, and therefore that would cause the rate to decrease, the concentration of catalyst increases, causing the rate to increase. So the rate's not going to drop the way it would in a batch reactor. And the question is, after 200 minutes of reaction, how many moles of the product do we have? So the first thing we want to do in all types of problems like this is draw a diagram that represents our system and label what we know. And so here's a representation of a semi-batch reactor. We know the initial volume in the reactor, 2,700 liters. We know the initial number of moles. That's going to be the initial concentration times the volume. And the initial concentration is 20 moles per liter. And the volume is 2,700 liters. So we have initially 54,000 moles of A. Number of moles of B initially is zero. The number of moles of C initially is zero. And now our feed, let's call that the molar flow rate of B. Well, that's the volumetric flow rate times the concentration of B coming into the reactor. The volumetric flow rate is 12.5 liters per minute. And the concentration is 0.05 moles per liter. So our molar flow rate of catalyst into reactor is 0.625 moles per minute. Also, what we're trying to determine is NC at 200 minutes. This is our unknown that we're solving for. And so what we want to do is write down mass balances for the system, and we're going to solve this numerically. That's the easiest way, and it's a more general way to solve this type problem. So what we're going to do is write down mass balances, and I'm going to write a mass balance for each of the components. So the derivative of Na, remember Na is the number of moles in the reactor at any time. That derivative respect to time is equal to the rate of reaction of A, which is the rate constant, the concentration A, concentration of B, and the volume of the reactor. Now, when we solve these mass balances, we have to know initial conditions. And initial conditions are the values at T equals zero. And we've just solved for this. This is 54,000 moles. Well, the mass balance for B is not reacting, it's a catalyst. So the only reason number of moles of B changes is because we're flowing B into the reactor. And of course, NB0 is equal to zero. So now we want the mass balance for C. Change the number of moles of C respect to time. Well, it's the rate that A is reacting. 1 mole of A makes 1 mole of C. This is a plus sign here. Initial conditions are this is also equal to 0. And then we need one more differential equation, and that's for the volume, because the volume is changing because of the volumetric flow rate coming into the reactor. This 12.5 liters per minute flowing into the reactor. It's a constant, and our initial volume is 2,700 liters. Now, in order to solve these equations with these initial conditions, we'll need some additional equations. We need to define CA, since that appears in the rate expression. It's the number of moles of A over volume, where both the number of moles of A changes with time and the volume changes with time. Likewise, CB is the number of moles of B with respect to volume. And then we're going to have to put in the values for K, FB, into the rate expressions, and V. So we need these three values. So I've written down the three constants we need to use, and now we're going to solve all this with Polymath. And with Polymath, we have to tell it our starting time and our final time, which is 200 minutes. Now we have everything we need to solve these differential equations. So I'm going to show you the Polymath solution. Obviously, there's other ways to solve this. This happens to be a particularly simple program. So we're using Polymath to solve the differential equations. And I'll show you now what the Polymath program looks like. So what I'm showing you on the left is a Polymath program. On the right is the output. Let's look at the left first. What I've written, the left column are the differential equations at the top with their initial conditions immediately below them using the Polymath format, which is important for making this work. This format where you can see there has to be parentheses around the units in the derivative term. Then our concentration of A and B are constants. Our starting and finishing integration time, and everything over here are just comments. And so with the number sign in front of something, it becomes a comment. On the right side is the output. We can get a graphical output. We're just looking at a table in this case, because what we want to determine is the number of moles of C. Started out as 0, and it finished at 27,990, so expect 28,000 moles of C in terms of significant figures after 200 minutes of reaction. Now, Polymath has additional, it shows the differential equations with the comments. It shows the other equations that we used and the various comments, and then gives you some information about error, etc. Very easy now with more complicated differential equations to use the same approach, and that's why it's good with this simpler case to just write a numerical solution. And so we can determine for the semi-batch reactor the number of moles of product after 200 minutes.